How do? So, I'm out in Snowdonia again. Again, it's been a while since I've been out. 6-7 weeks or so. Today though, I'm going up the side of Snowdon. On the quieter side though. There's not a lot of people out here on this side. The group bouldering over there. But not seen anyone else going up on this side. So, the last few times I've been out, I've made plans for my camps, and then it's never turned out, so kind of winging it this time. There's a small town that I'm aiming for, but if we get there, we get there. If we don't, we don't. So, but the sun's out, it's dry, there shouldn't be too much wind tonight. And it's going to be relatively cold, but not too bad. Still got my winter bag with me, but I think it's only going to get down to about 1 or 2 degrees. It says the wind chill is about -5, but I'll be in the tent for most of it anyway, so quite a warm one. Pack actually feels pretty light for once. Normally, it's absolutely kill me by this point. So I've got just enough water for my walk. I've got the filter with me in case I need to top up. So it should be a good one. I did forget though to bring some beer. It's like a steep climb. I'm so unfit. Probably can't tell. Ooh, this is steep. Good fun though. We're nearly at the top now. Just a bit further. Made it. Look at this. I think this has got to be one of the best places I've gone to so far. This is incredible. Hopefully I don't fall in. Right, I might get the tent up now. The only negative about this bit, the ground is quite soggy, it's quite sodden. So I might have to go towards the edge, where it's a little bit drier. The trusty Hike and Shore pillow again. It's one of my favourites now. So I'll do this in comfort and sit down. And I've also been sent a new head torch from Sunblesa to test and give them some feedback. You'll probably see a lot of YouTubers with these, giving them away and stuff. So quite interested to see how well it does. It's a lot lighter than the current head torch that I use. I use the, I think it's an Alpkit Quark at the moment, but it's quite heavy. And even though it has a rechargeable battery, you've got to take that out and plug that in separately. It's a bit of a faff. With this one, yeah, got a USB port on the bottom, you just plug straight in so I can charge it while I'm out as well. The thing that grabs me most is just how light it is. You can hardly feel that it's there. I had a little bit of a play around with it at home. It seems really bright, more than enough for wild camping. So I'll put a link in the description of where you can get these from, how much they are. But so far I'm really impressed with this. Looks like a quality piece of kit. But we'll see tonight. But yeah, so it comes with that. It comes with a little carry case. Micro USB cable. That would be the only thing I would personally change on it. It'd be better if it was USB-C or something, but still good, still all right. Oh, that water's cold. Get it filtered. It's that I'm hungry. Need some hot food, a cup of tea maybe. Or a hot chocolate. Definitely a hot chocolate. Okay. Let's see what I've got. Ooh. Chicken fajita with rice. And then some wraps to put it in. And then I've got slight squashed doughnut. Can't beat a Twix. Cereal bar thing, fruit and grain. Raspberry sponge pudding.
and then some tomato and herb pasta if I get hungry later on. And some prawn cocktail crisp for later as well. Well, I'm not going to go hungry. Gone with the speedster stove again for today. It seems to be the only one I go for now. I barely touch my gas stove. Price of gas canisters now has just got crazy. Not a bad view from the tent though. Now, it doesn't look appetizing, but I promise you, it is nice. Got this apple energy drink, best before 5th 2020. I'm sure it'll be all right. Tastes like weak apple juice.
It's like a perfect night. Hardly any wind. It's not that cold. Morning. It's another great night. Hardly any wind at all. Right, look at the clag though. Right, so I'm just going to get packed up, I think. Have a cup of tea. And then head off. Oh, it's cold this morning though. I'm not going to hang around for too long. I'm going to get packed up. Okay, that's me all packed up. And as usual, leave no trace. So you can't even tell where I've been. I am going to have a bit of a moan though. This is probably one of the nicest spots I've camped at. But people are ruining it with... You see the scorch marks from when they've had campfires. And then there's no need for it at all. Hacking at the tree, for what I presume for wood for the campfire. I mean, how stupid can you get? Right, anyway, enough of my moan. So I'm going to start heading down. I'm going to try a different route back down, because coming up it was quite steep, so going down again with big heavy pack, don't know. So I'm just going to try a different route and see if that's any better. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so I'm nearly back at the car now. I didn't really film an awful lot coming back down. Sections of it were pretty steep. And then got chatting to a guy who was well camping on just over the ridge from where I was. So I'll probably end it here because I can see the car. But if you've made it this far, thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next one.